figlia mia, butta dure, mamma mia, già pensa tu. Se tu rulla gangare, e tu vai, e tu vieni, se non sa se c'è manetene. Se ti piace i maccaroni, mi piace spaghetti pure. C'è la luna mezzo mare, mamma mia, mi è male da te. Figlia mia.
Today we're going to learn how to make spadini or bracchioli. In Italian, it means very small, or the bracciolo would be a much larger size steak, and it's a rolled steak. The spadini comes from Sicily, so Sicilian. This is a Sicilian recipe, and again, this is another one of Grandma Leone's great recipes that she passed down to us. Now, what I love about this recipe, different parts of Italy do all kinds of different things with the filling inside. Now, again, my grandma would put the cheese and the prosciutto inside of hers. But then when I talked to Jim's grandma, she would put raisins or something sweet because that part of Italy had the grapes. And then another Italian you may speak with, they may put eggs, a boiled egg inside. Some of the Italians use the toothpicks, and some of the Italians use string to actually tie the meat together. So it's really fun learning about the different parts of Italy, what they do. But once again, this is Grandma Leone and Sicily, Sicilian, her version of spadini. We make these for dinner a lot of times during the week because it's so easy to do. And then they could be put into the sauce as well. All right, so here's what you need. You definitely need your favorite cheese. And I love Parmigiano-Reggiano. Bacon, I'm gonna cheat. I just bought bacon bits, but you could do actual broiled bacon, or pancetta is fabulous inside of these. You're gonna need your thin steak, your bracchioli, the meat, or if you can't find that, tell the butcher you need something thin. You actually could even use a London broil for this. That's up to you. But at our grocery store here in Cleveland, at Heinen's, they have the bracciolo meat, or at Giant Eagle, they have bracciolo, and you can ask for that. You need some kind of parsley, fresh parsley, wonderful plum or cherry tomatoes, and I actually took the time to cut them. Once again, if you want to do the toothpicks, you're welcome to do that. We always see how many people have eaten the spadinis. We count how many toothpicks they have, and then we could tell how many spadinis they ate at Christmas time. I like using the skewers. So that's what we do at our house. Because like I said, I do this after work. I cook this for a meal during the regular work week. I like using saran wrap. I line my countertop with saran wrap. I know some people pull out a cutting board. I just don't like to mix the meat on top of a cutting board. So I actually cover my counter with a saran wrap, or you can put aluminum foil down. And then all the mess stays on that, and then I just throw that out all at one time. You're also gonna need some breadcrumbs. Once again, we have wonderful Orlando here in Cleveland, or Progressive breadcrumbs, whoever you can get your breadcrumbs from. And your cooking scissors. Now, I have a special pair that I just leave in the kitchen, so I'm not using this for school. I'm using this to cut meat, so I like doing that. I don't like using a knife to cut this. It goes so much faster with cutting the actual beef that you're gonna use. So, and a couple spoons. Okay, so those are the main ingredients. All right, now what I've done is I've already taken the beef bracciolo meat out of the package, and I'm gonna make like an assembly line now. So I'm putting generous helpings of the cheese on all of the slices that I have of the beef. And then I'm gonna add my fresh parsley.
Once again, here in Cleveland, we have this great Italian import store called Gallucci. So it's pretty easy to get these supplies and check in your nearby towns what you have available. And then I'm gonna take the bacon bits. And again, you could do pancetta, you could do prosciutto, you know, if you like that better, but I kind of like bacon bits. I would also recommend, if you have time, you know, to actually broil your bacon on your own. All right, so again, I'm being generous in each one of them. And now I'm gonna make sure each one of them gets a cherry or grape tomato. And I'm gonna give each one, and I've already cut those up, you know, and I washed them prior to using them. And this is the fun part, what I said that you could do, either use the toothpicks, or I think it's so much easier using the skewer, and I'm gonna use that to thread the rolled steak into the skewer. Okay, so watching carefully and closely, I'm just going to make sure I try to capture all the ingredients, and I'm just gonna carefully roll it and place it on the skewer. So you will need some kind of a pan that you're going to be able to do broil, you know, use the broiling element. Okay, I think our meat is broiled. Looks delicious. Okay. So now what you could do is you can get your salad ready and some ciabatta bread, and you got a complete dinner. Now, I'm just gonna demonstrate that you can put one of these into the sauce, and again, it could absorb all the wonderful sauce. You could actually, like I said, you could cook your spadini in the sauce, but like I said, my family likes it this way better. So, mangia, enjoy.